Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to this very special edition of the Cross Media Café, which we call Holland's Finest. First of all, this event is organized by Media Perspectives and the Sound and Vision, which is the Dutch Institute for Media Culture, and it's all about innovation. And just a few moments to think, why is media tech so important? The media industry is always in change, and it's always driven by technological developments. This is not something new, but what is new that sometimes now we think that all this innovation is driven by a few Silicon Valley actors, and that other countries are just following their lead. And to be honest, this is not true. A lot of the media innovation is taking place in the tech that is underlying the media landscape. And everybody is, you know, innovating. And a lot of this tech is coming from other countries. And the Netherlands is actually a very good one.
Erik van Heeswijk, founder, co-owner, CEO of Smart Octo.
Yes.
What does Smart Octo mean?
Well, Smart Octo is a smart octopus, but we have sort of taken that creature because it's a very intelligent animal, but in a sense it's editorial analytics, right? We help newsrooms making sense of data.
Yeah, so it's Smart Octopus.
It's Smart Octopus.
And Jouko Huismans?
Yes.
Prepper.
Yeah.
We have a video about Prepper as well. So I would suggest let's first roll the videos and then discuss a little bit of what the companies exactly do and how you see the developments in the future. We start with Smart Octo video.
To stretch the life cycle of your stories, Smart Octo draws on your omnichannel data to identify those stories that call for an adjustment. It could be an A/B test of your header, the advice to post it on social again, or write an update. All of this is related to your success metrics. Smart Octo provides feedback that helps make your online storytelling efforts profitable, depending on your business model. Online subscriptions, paywalls, growing your follower base, we know the drill.
So Erik, let me get this clear. This is a tool, in my words, but correct me if I'm wrong, in my words, a tool that helps editors to know what happens with their content.
Yes, in a sense, yes. We have all come from media industries, right, and media companies. So we are actually media people looking at data. And so we make reports, we make real-time dashboards, we do A/B testing. So we make sense of the data for them. But it's really special on two fronts, actually. We go beyond the vanity metrics. So it's, of course, we have the page views and we have the stream starts, etc. But we have really deep metrics to know what's going on with your content. That's one. And secondly, which is even more unique on a sort of a global scale, is we've made all these algorithms that help you make sense of it in doing the action, right? We have tips that automatically calculate the best scenario for every story. And we do that for like 120 newsrooms now. So I think within a couple of years, we have become the most advanced editorial analytics system of Europe, actually. So that's really something to be proud of.
Perfect, perfect. We're going to look to the video of Prepper first, and then we'll discuss a little bit more about Prepper.
Content is everywhere. So, to make a difference, your content must stand out. But this doesn't happen on its own. For this, you need the right tools and the right data that help you build a stronger connection with your audience. Meet Prepper, the world's first data-driven headless CMS. With a revolutionary graph database, we combine the power of content and data to help you maximize the impact of your content. Our core is a headless CMS with all the features that a headless CMS requires. And on top of that, Prepper comes with 5 additional tools that help you really connect with your audience. Many leading content teams already use Prepper to publish content across the web, build modern Jamstack applications, and boost e-commerce results. It's time to combine the power of content and data to maximize the impact of your content. It's time for Prepper, the data-driven headless CMS.
That's a nice video.
Yes.
And they talk about, the video says headless CMS. What's a headless CMS?
Yes, what is a headless CMS? Headless CMS means that you have a presentation layer. That's, for example, a touch point like a website or an app. And that's separated from the layer where you manage the content and data.
Right.
So with the headless CMS, you bring in one place all your content and data, so you can publish it on multiple channels from one place.
Yeah.
And that's called headless CMS.
Right.
But we go a step further because we think that the future of content management is more data-driven, and publishing is not really the biggest challenge. It's about building an audience around your brand with content.
Okay.
So we help our customers to maximize the impact of the content and to have more people coming to your website, to have you know, return more often with better retention, so they spend more time, more interactions. So we provide, of course, headless CMS, but also 5 tools that help them to maximize the impact. For example, they can have an optimized tool for SEO optimization, A/B testing, or a tool to notify people for the comment for the content they really like and they follow, but also a tool for capturing interaction data and recommendations, and all to help you make the impact with your content and build up your audience.
Yeah, well, because I'm not that familiar with CMSs, that's why I ask questions about headless CMS.
Yeah.
But CMS, to me, it's usually organize your content and your content distribution.
Yes,
but
for your online channels. Yeah, it could be an app, website, landing page, podcast.
Multi-platform. But you said there is an add-on.
Yes.
We measure also the reach and audience
because
reach.
Publishing alone is not enough, because after publishing, the whole game starts with optimizing and creating more impact, like Smart Octo also does for editorial teams.
Yeah.
We provide them also tools to maximize the impact, because it's a battle out there. There's so much content, so much to get the attention, to get people to your content. That's quite a struggle. And so we have the technology to provide data-driven tools to use data to maximize the impact.
Yeah. So basically, those two companies, they really fit good to each other.
We know each other. So that's it's also an illustration of the fact that we have sort of aligning capacities and aligning visions, right? So we know that data-inspired working or data-driven working is the way to go now. Like 5 or 6 years ago, you would definitely have to sell that vision. Nowadays, that's common. Every system that helps and assists newsrooms or marketing teams in that journey is an important topic. Yeah.
And how do you guys see the development of AI-based, algorithm-based creating of content?
Yeah, we had to sort of break through some barriers there as well, right? Because these algorithms, well, for example, journalists, they are very sort of smart people, and they think they know it all, right? I've been a journalist my whole life, so I can pretty much tell you.
Some of them do know quite a lot, but okay,
of course.
Yeah.
And so, in order for an AI system or an algorithm to assist them and tell them, maybe you should bring that story to Facebook, or as we do even, maybe you should make a follow-up story and make it personal, for example. If you have that kind of algorithm, you'll be sure to have some cultural issues there as well. But if it proves to be right, just like Waze or Google Maps in your car, if it proves to be right and every time you say left is the better way to go, in the end, you'll be able to assist them and help them and connect to them.
But I'm pretty serious, because these are all, you know, this is this year was the year of everybody talking about fake news, et cetera, et cetera.
Yes.
And there is all kinds of ethical things in here. If you would have a machine which you said, okay, because you measure all the output for the editorial and where's the output going. If you have a machine which replaces basically the journalist and you can provide the audience, would that work? Would you collaborate with that?
Yeah, I think there is sort of, in the content, you don't sort of take one for all, right? So there's high-level content, which makes it really personal, narrative.
Yeah.
That will really hard to be replaced, right? At the lower ends of that, taking a tweet out or something like that really simple stuff, content stuff, I'm pretty sure in the coming 5 years
what
that
do
will
you
be
think?
Automated.
Yeah, okay.
Oh, well,
audience building automatically by algorithm.
Yes, for sure. The algorithms are going to be very important. What you see a lot is that personalization is really a topic. So there's so much content, but what content is relevant for you? What content inspires you? And you see that also, of course, the big tech companies like Facebook and Twitter, your timeline is different than my timeline.
Sure.
It's also interesting to see that platforms like Medium.com is a big blogging platform, and you get every day a personalized email with relevant content. And it's all algorithm-based, but also like Spotify last week, they sent your Wrapped 2020. That's a personalized experience based on data with algorithms. So these kind of personalizations, these are very interesting.
Yeah, but I think we both believe that in the end, you should always bring that intelligence to people as well, right? Because they are the narrators, they are the makers.
Correct. Yeah, and you,
it's both. Okay, it's a bit of both. Yeah.
We only have one question left, and that's a question for the both of you. This is an international audience. We talked about building audiences. Yeah. So tell me just briefly, where are you on the international level at the moment? Eric.
Yeah, we are in 15 countries, 120 newsrooms with reporting, with dashboarding. So we have Latin American customers, and we have Chinese customers, and we are basically all over. The main focus now is Northwestern Europe. That's where the bulk of our customers are. But we are all over the place. Yeah.
Okay, good.
Yeah, yes, we can deliver, of course, worldwide. We have a global CDN connected and cached API, so technically we can serve the whole world. But business-wise, we're focusing now on Europe, because that's the first market, and after that we go maybe abroad.
But if the people chat and ask you, can you come over here?
We can deliver worldwide. Okay. No problem.
Guys, I would like to thank you very much for being Holland Finest. Okay.